Very good morning, student. Student, in the last class, we have discussed the relations between algebraic coefficient of ratios of a linear pair of equations and their graphical representation. And the condition for intersecting line was if a1 by a2 not equals b1 by b2, then the line will be intersecting line. And intersecting lines always have one solution, exactly one solution, that is unique solution. And if any equation have solution, then we call this consistent pair of solution. And if my three ratios, that is a1 by a2 equals b1 by b2 equals c1 by c2, then the lines are coincident line, means they will coincide each other, and there are infinite many solutions, and solution is again consistent pair of lines. And third condition was if a1 by a2 equals b1 by b2 but not equals c1 by c2, then the lines will be parallel line, and parallel line never intersect, so it has no solution and inconsistent pair of lines. A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2 are the coefficient of pair of equation in two variable. A1, A2 is coefficient for x, B1, B2 is coefficient for y, and C1, C2 is constant. And then we have discussed their graphical method to solve the linear pair of equation in two variable. And today we will start our algebraic methods. We have three different algebraic methods. First is substitution method, second is elimination method, and third is cross multiplication method. Today we will only discuss substitution method. So in substitution method, our first step will be find the value of any one variable. We have two types of variable, that is x and y. You can find any variable, value of any variable in term of other variable. Means if we want, find the value of a variable, say x, in term of y from either equation. We have given two equation, we will find the value of one variable from any equation and put that value in second equation. Substitute this value in other equation. Now the second equation will be only in one variable. Now you can solve the variable. Say, now we will find the value of y. If we find, in first step we find the value of x, then we can solve second, from second equation, value of y without in any variable. And third step will be substitute this value in first equation, and then you will find the value of again x. Now it will be better clear to you through an example. Say, solve x plus y equals 14. This is my first equation, that is x plus y equals 14 and x minus y equals 4, by using substitution method. Now, first step is find the value of any variable from either of the equation. Now, say x plus 14y is my first equation and x minus y equals 4 is my second equation. I will find the value of x. I will find the value of x from first equation. You can find the value of x from second equation. Both the answer will be same. The choice will be that which makes our solution convenient or easy. Now, from equation 1. Now, equation 1. X plus y equals 14. Then this y will become minus y when it move on right hand side. Then this will become x equals 14 minus y. This is my first step. Now, the second step was put this value, substitute this value in second equation so that our one variable can be eliminated. Now substitute the value of x in equation second, then replace this x with 14 minus y. Then 14 minus y and minus minus y equals this 4. Now solving this, you will get 14 minus 2y equals 4, and minus 2y will become minus 10 and the y will be 5. Student, सबसे पहले हमने क्या किया है, किसी भी एक इक्वेशन को यूज करके हमने एक वेरिएबल की वैल्यू फाइंड की है इन टर्म ऑफ सेकंड वेरिएबल. से दिस इज x की जो वैल्यू हमने फाइंड की है वो सेकंड वेरिएबल दैट इज y की टर्म में फाइंड की है, और उस वैल्यू को हमने दूसरी इक्वेशन में सेकंड इक्वेशन में पुट कर दिया है सो दैट वी कैन फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ दैट वेरिएबल. नाउ वी हैव ओनली वन वेरिएबल, से दिस इज y एंड वी फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ y. Now substitute this value in equation 1. You can also substitute this value in equation 2. Both with the answer will be same. Now put the value of y in equation 1. Here you will get x plus y, that is 5. X plus y equals 14 and x is 9. If you put the value of this y in second equation, then you will get x minus 5 equal 4 and x equals 9. दोनों से सेम आंसर मिलेगा. फर्स्ट स्टेप, कोई भी एक इक्वेशन यूज करो और किसी एक वेरिएबल की वैल्यू फाइंड कर लो इन टर्म ऑफ सेकेंड वेरिएबल. देन सब्स्टिट्यूट दैट वैल्यू इन सेकेंड इक्वेशन, यू विल फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ वन वेरिएबल एंड देन सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस वैल्यू अगेन इन एनी ऑफ द इक्वेशन, you will find the value of another variable. And my answer, x equals 9 and y equals 5. Now, solve 7x minus 15y equals 2 and x plus 2y plus 3, x plus 2y equals 3 by substitution method. Now student, my first equation is 7x minus 15y equals 2. This is my first equation. And x plus 2y equals 3. This is my second equation. And you, if you find that, if you notice that, second equation is easy to solve. If I want to find the value of x, then by using second equation, this will be easy. Because x equals 3 minus 2y. But if I am using first equation, then there will be 7 in the denominator. So for the convenience, we will use second equation. From second equation, x equals 3 minus 2y. Now put this value in equation 1. अगर हम यहाँ पे second equation use कर रहे हैं, तो हम यहाँ जो जो value put करेंगे, वो कहाँ पे put करेंगे? First equation में. Now put the value. In first equation, we will get replace this x with 3 minus 2y. Now 7 into 3 minus 2y minus 15y equals to as it is. Now solving this, 7 into 3 21, 7 into minus 2 that is minus 14y and minus 15y equals 2. Now this 21 when goes on the right side, then it will become minus, this will become minus 19. Minus 19. Then y will be minus 19 divided by minus 29, and minus minus will be cancel out. This will become y equals 19 divided by 29. Now put this value in either of the equation. Now second equation is easy to use, so put this value in equation 2. Put the value of y in equation 2, we will get x plus 2 into y. Y is 19 divided by 29 equals 3. And you will get x equals 49 divided by 29. My y is 19 by 29 and x is 49 divided by 29. Now, my word problem is given that the difference between two numbers, here we have given difference between two number is 26 and one number is 3 times the other. You know that we let that value which we have to find. Here we have to find the values of the value of that number. So let that numbers. Now you know that one number is 3 times the other, means one is greater and other is smaller. So let the greater number x and smaller y, or say let the first number x and second number y. Now according to statement, the difference between two number is 26, means x minus y equals 26 or y minus x 26. Depend karega ki x greater assume kar rahe ho ya fir y greater assume kar rahe ho. If I'm assuming x greater than y, then x minus y means difference will be x minus y equals 26 if I'm assuming x greater than y. But if I'm assuming y greater than x, then this will be reverse. And the second situation said that one number is 3 times the other. You know that the greater number is always the 3 times the smaller. So x will be x equals 3 y. This is my second equation. Now again solve the equation by using substitution method. And now you can see that second equation is easy to use because it is already in second variable. Now from second equation we have x equals 3y and substitute this value in equation 1. Now 3y minus y equals 26 and 2y will become 26, y will become 13. This is my value of y, and substitute this value in equation 2. Because equation 2 is easy, then you will get x equals 3 into y, that is 13, 3 into 13, that is 39. So two numbers are 39 and 13. Now the larger of two supplementary angles, first you have you should know the meaning of this supplementary angle. The meaning of this supplementary angle means the angle whose sum is 180 degrees. The larger of two supplementary angles exceeds the smaller by 18 degrees. Find the angles. Now again let the larger angle add the smaller angle. Let the larger angle x degree. Student, take care of this unit. Always write here the unit which we are using in statement. Here we are talking about an angle and the unit of angle is degree. And but if there we have given a radian, that is 18 radian, then we will use here radian. But mostly a degree he mentioned karta hai, toh degree mention kijiye yahan pe. X degree and y degree will be the smaller angle. Now according to statement, larger angle, that is x, exceeds the smaller by 18. First equation was x equal, my first equation is x equal y plus 18, and second equation will be this supplementary angles, that is x plus y will be 180, because sum of supplementary angle is 180 degree. Now from equation 1, that is x equals y plus 18, we will substitute this value in equation 2. Put the value of equation from equation 1 in equation 2. This will become 18 plus y equals 118, and on solving you will get the value of y equals 81. Now substitute this value in equation 1, you will get x equals 81 plus 18, that is 99, and the angle will be 99 and 81. So two angles are 81 degrees and 99 degrees. Student, ये भी अलग से मेंशन करना है कि जो उसने पूछा उसको सीधा यहीं पे आपने स्किप नहीं कर देना. सो यहीं पे लिख के नहीं छोड़ना. आपको ये मेंशन करना है टू एंगल्स आर 81 डिग्री एंड 99 डिग्री, बिकॉज दिस इज वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स, नॉट द एंगल. वी हैव अज्यूम द वैल्यू द स्मॉलर एंगल एज एक्स और लार्जर एंगल से एक्स, बट यू हैव टू मेंशन सेपरेटली द वैल्यूज ऑफ एंगल्स आर दिस. Now in exercise 3.3 you have to solve this numerical and the word problems. Now in equation second, that is solve this and hence find the value of m for which y equals mx plus 3. Means first you will find the value of x and y from this equation, and then put the value of x and y in this and solve for x. Okay, student, thank you and have a nice day.